I'm Daniel Czech. I'm a postdoctoral scholar with Breakthrough Listen. I work primarily on our commensal SETI survey that we're doing with the MeerKAT Radio Telescope in South Africa. Why do I like MeerKAT? Well, I suppose I'm partly biased as a South African. There's a lot to like about MeerKAT. This is something that one could spend a lot of time speaking about, but MeerKAT is a radio telescope in a very remote region in South Africa, in the Northern Cape. It's one of the least populated parts of the country, and it's located in a radio quiet area, so there's no local transmission. And the telescope itself is very interesting design. It consists of 64 offset Gregorian antennas, so these are dishes that look a little bit more like a television receiving dish, where the receiver is kind of offset from the center, from the main dish. And it's a telescope that was designed as a potential pathfinder for the Square Kilometer Array, which is a much larger project. It's got a number of interesting features that make it very suitable for SETI. The data processing architecture is centered around an Ethernet network, so multiple experiments can receive the same data simultaneously, which is very useful for us with our commensal survey. And the other aspect of this that maybe is not really the telescope itself, but the people that one gets to work with in South Africa, I really enjoy working with everybody who's involved in this project. People have been very helpful and very accommodating. And we've just returned from a trip to install a bunch of computers at the data center. We put in 16 processing nodes. So these are the big 4U computers. So they're quite large and they're quite powerful. We have enough computing resources there now to process the full bandwidth in kind of double duty, which is kind of the original design spec for our system. At MeerKAT, we're an entirely commensal survey, so we observe without any control over the telescope. So while a primary observer is looking at whatever sources on the sky that are of interest to them, we get the same data from them and we can conduct our SETI survey on that data. But one of the challenges with this is every primary observer's observing strategy is different, and so there are many different configurations for the telescope that we have to be able to manage. So an observation for us as the kind of commensal user, we just receive data that the telescope is moving into position, that it's been configured, that a primary observer is setting up an observation. They specify a whole bunch of parameters that the telescope then kind of configures. They specify things like what observing band it is, where it will be pointing, for how long, what kind of calibrators it'll observe in between, what kind of calibration will be done. And from our point of view, we programmatically receive all of this information, and then we set up our system such that it can process the data according to these parameters, and then we record. And recording takes place for us in sort of short chunks, about 5 minutes in length, record interesting candidate signals, and then clear the buffers and start again until the primary observer is finished with their observation. We are searching for evidence of intelligent life. So this is something that's quite difficult to do at interstellar distances. So we're using technology as a proxy. This has been said before by Jill Tarter, eminent people in the field. But what we're trying to do is detect evidence of intelligent life. And one of the things we look for are radio signals that could only have been produced from a technological origin. So we kind of tailor our searches for signals such as these. One of the fantastic things about working with Breakthrough Listen is that you have access to other radio telescopes as well. So you get to see how these systems work kind of across the field, across all these different instruments, attached to these highly sophisticated, sensitive radio telescopes, you know, the most potent radio telescopes in the world. We are doing SETI at a rate that is like orders of magnitude more than previous searches, especially with like our survey with MeerKAT, and there's some other SETI surveys coming online as we speak, also with the VLA, for example. So our capabilities are improving manyfold, and I mean, what's not to like? I mean, it's awesome. It combines engineering, which I love, with working on a really important question. It's one of these questions that I think will be asked for a long time still, you know, until we, you know, have the answer. But even then, I think it will be there'll be even greater interest in it.